Okay, let's talk puzzles. So we're looking at cognitive stimulation, and we want to offer them something that's going to engage the brain. Puzzles can be a really great thing for them. However, the number of pieces and the type of puzzle matters. In my program, I don't use anything over 100 pieces. And a lot of times, I use the 24 pieces, the 36 up, and sometimes I'll use the 60 piece. What I find is even in that stage five, when they're getting closer to stage six, what I'm going to see is they're not necessarily looking at the picture to put the puzzle together. I mean, they will pull like colors together so they can sort by colors. But what they're looking at is the edges, and they'll take one round edge and they'll try to put it in every single hole to see where it fits. And then even when it does not fit, they think it fits well enough. So, the least number of puzzle pieces, the easier it is for them to manipulate and find those pieces and come together. I will say this also, it's very important when you're doing puzzles that if they're not able to do the puzzle by themselves, you don't leave them. You don't step away, or they're going to get frustrated. So we have to understand if they're going to get frustrated, we stay there. Now, if they're later, a little later in the disease process, and they're just content to push those puzzle pieces together and move them around, and they're big puzzle pieces, and you don't have to worry about choking risk, then you can set them down and let them manipulate them. Because at that point, it's not necessarily about them putting that puzzle together as much it is manipulating the pieces. And then when you're able to, you can sit down with them and put that puzzle piece together and then talk about what that picture is. So that's nice too. So I do use a lot of children's and toddler puzzles in my program. I try not to use cartoonish characters unless it's like kind of a drawing of a farm and it looks cartoonish, but it's not like overly cartoonish. I want them to be able to see what that picture represents. And so they have some pieces that are they're just the toddlers where they got the little knobs, and there's a goat, and there's a pig, and there's a cow, and there's a barn, and they just pull those pieces up. So they're super simple to hold and manipulate, and they can pick those pieces up, and it's easier for them to find where the hole goes because there's less pieces, and they're able to manipulate it, and it kind of falls in. Those are really good, for some of our residents because one, they can see the picture of the horse, so they're thinking about horses. They can see the cow, so they're thinking about a cow. And you can even sit and do some cow trivia or discussion about the farm. And, sometimes, and I'll say this again and again, it's not always about completing the activity, it's about the engagement while you're doing it. So, the reminiscing about farms, that can be the activity. So yeah, they've got these puzzle pieces and they got a random cow over here and a random sheep over here, but it's okay because it's about them thinking. So yeah, they're thinking about where those pieces are going, but now they're also thinking about, oh, that's right. I grew up on a farm. I used to feed the chickens. I used to have to milk the cows. I had a dog that barked all the time. So do I. Anyway, those kind of things. So you have to really sit down and do puzzles with them to know which puzzles are the best ones for them and which ones aren't. I don't try to use puzzles that have a lot of one color. I want there to be a lot of picture in the puzzle, so that they can at least sort those into colors and start putting those together. If you have a picture with a lot of blue sky, those blues are hard for us, let alone for them. So we want them to be able to find the pieces easier, and you can do that when there's a lot of different, you know, colored flowers and different things in the picture. And so if it does have a blue sky, that's the part you help with. So when you sit down to do a puzzle with someone, different stages can have different jobs, and that's okay. You can have somebody be the one that turns the puzzle pieces over. You can have somebody be the one to find the edge.